is Dora from Ultimate Success Coaches. Hope you are doing well, healthy and sporty out there. Now, today I have come also with a running shoe review. And of course, we are really approaching the end of 2021, which means also that we are making all sorts of lists, top 3, top 5 best running shoes of the year, plated shoes, non-plated shoes, race shoes, training shoes, max shoes. It's like that, all sorts of chocolate. Now, in the non-plated shoe category, and definitely the tempo day shoe category, we might have a winner this year, and that's the New Balance Rebel version 2. Super lightweight shoe for tempo days, for those quick runs, no plates, just old school. But what is not old school? That's the midsole foam. You guessed it. So let's go to the details. It has a 6mm drop, 26 in the heel and 20mm in the forefoot, which is kind of in the middle, not too high, but it's okay. Super good fit of the upper, a meshed upper. I went through to size, which means 40.5 UK 7 for myself. The weight, as I mentioned, super lightweight, is more or less the same category as the Nike Vaporfly Next Percent. In my size, it's 185 grams. Yes, 185 grams. And the official men's weight is 210 grams. Just super. Let's go to the four categories I usually compare the shoes for. And the first one is the upper and the fit. What can I say on the upper and the fit? This is just 10 out of 10. I cannot start with anything else. Went through to size, super engineered mesh upper, breathable. It keeps your feet secure, absolutely. Interesting asymmetric lacing, though the laces are for my liking a bit too much, a bit too long, but I will replace anyway this lace with that quick lacing, so it doesn't matter really for now. It is not a gusseted tongue, you can see it's just moving everywhere, but it is perfectly fitting, really no issues with the tongue moving. I don't mind if it's not gusseted, if it's just in this place, perfect. No heel slippage, it just kept my feet totally secure. You can see it's quite built for a tempo day shoe, also quite high on the Achilles, but I didn't have any irritation on the Achilles. Would I change anything? No, I don't think so. It's just perfect as it is. I also love the design of this simple New Balance logo, but it here still says which company it is. I really like this, so yeah, 10 out of 10. Second, let's talk about the midsole and the cushioning. Now, something new as the Fuelsole foam, super. I didn't have the version 1, I heard quite positive opinions from my friends about the version 1, but this is just an upgrade. It's really like marshmallow, super, super, you can see. Really, you can just push it fully together, and my hands are really not strong. When I put it on the first time as well, it was like really walking on the clouds. Super energy return. I went yesterday for the first run in this shoe because I had it for several weeks, but because of my full distance triathlon, I was not testing any shoes really the weeks leading up to that race. So that's why I took it out this week, and I loved I'm just coming back also on a normal running shape after that triathlon, and this was really the first session where I was enjoying running from the first moment until the last moment. It was pushing me further, it gave that super energy return, which you usually don't see from most non-plated shoes. We are so much used to plated shoes, even for trainings, for example, the Endorphin Speed, I also really take out regularly for long runs and tempo runs. And for non-plated, this is just a great one. So that's why I'm giving 9 out of the 10, because it's just perfect. I love this. Let's talk about one of the other key items, and that's the outsole. You can see there is quite some exposed midsole foam, but it's not at strategic places, so that's okay. And because it's of course a lightweight shoe, they are really, really sparing with that outsole rubber. You can see two different types of outsole rubber. This one is called Endurance. This is the more durable, I would say. And this is the issue. After one run of 8 kilometers, where I did 15 minutes in zone 2 and 10 minutes in zone 3, so that's half marathon pace, I already see some damage of the rubber. Of course, the shoe is for usage, so I don't mind if it's just getting a bit used after a few sessions. But what is your expectation from the shoe? Because I was running yesterday really in rainy conditions, Dutch autumn. The grip was also not 100%. I would say it's a good medium grip, but not really for the rainy conditions. It was not dangerous, but I have some other shoes with better grip. And it also means, of course, they are just putting less rubber out there. So if you are expecting this shoe for go for that 700-800 kilometers, then it's not your choice. This shoe, I'm expecting 300-500 max kilometers. Also depends on your weight and how much your knees and legs can bear, basically how much cushioning you need really on your tempo days as well. Because if you want to have that full benefit of the shoe, I'm a bit afraid that around 300-400 kilometers, this will be just used. Because also it's just super soft. So that means also for the outsole, I gave 7 out of the 10. It's not bad, for no means it's bad, and because of the tempo, because of the weight, you are giving something up, and it's the outsole. Now, the first category, the last one, is about price and value. Didn't mention the price yet. Here in Europe, it retails for 139 euros. That's the full price. Now, I wanted to go for another colorway, to be honest, and that's the London Marathon colorway. Totally, now this weekend is the London Marathon, so I wanted to purchase that already like a month ago because that was for retail for several sites, but it seems that it was not really in stock, so that's why I had to go for the other colorway, which I love as well. This red and orange is a weird combination, but it works out really nicely. I was surprised myself as well. Also with this kind of teal blue, which is one of my favorite colors basically. So I didn't go for that London colorway. And I went for this colorway, but it meant also that this was on sale for 65 euros. That was a bargain for 65 euros, but let's go for the full price, so that's 139, and you can already find on some sales like 20-30% easily, because also quite some colorways are out for this shoe, and I expect that later on the year it will be even more sales. Black Friday coming, of course, as well next month. I would still say for 139, it's a nice shoe. You are not getting thousands of kilometers, no way. So if you need really one all-around shoe, then you should not pick this one and go for something which is more durable on the outsole. This is not the strong point of the shoe. But for a tempo day shoe, a non-plated shoe, it's a great one for this price. So that's why this is getting 8 points out of 10 points. Which is bringing us for a total of 8.5 out of 10. 8.5. Since I have this scoring system, it's the best shoe ever. What can I say? It is not without a reason in the beginning. I mentioned most likely this will be one of the top shoes of the year. Now this was my review of the New Balance Rebel version 2. I hope you liked the video. And if you did, please give the thumbs up. See you in the next video. Take care. Bye.